Welcome back to the course on Advanced Switchgear. Today we are going to see about air brake circuit breakers and its construction. An arc interruption in oil is due to generation of hydrogen gas owing to oil decomposition. When an oil circuit breaker is used, the medium used is oil. So, to interrupt the arc, oil get decomposed and it produces hydrogen gas, and this hydrogen gas which is present in decomposition of oil quench the arc. This fact make us to study the arc interruption in air. We know air consists of all the type of gases. Hydrogen gas is also present in air. So we can study about the properties of hydrogen gas which is present in the air, which can be useful for arc interruption. Arc interruption properties of hydrogen is much superior to air. Since hydrogen is a dielectric material, so this hydrogen gas can be used instead of air to quench the arc, because the dielectric properties of hydrogen gas is very high. There are several advantages over the oil as quenching medium. These are elimination of fire risk and maintenance associated with the use of oil. If a hydrogen gas is used, only we need to purchase air so that we can use the hydrogen which is present in the air so that the arc can be extinguished. If an oil circuit breaker is purchased, we need to purchase oil, and this oil should be of good dielectric strength. Since a lot of interruption occur in a circuit breaker, so the dielectric strength of oil gets decreased for a time. So the decrease of dielectric strength in oil due to increase of time gap can be avoided by inserting or by adding pure oil with pure dielectric material. So the maintenance associated with the use of oil circuit breaker is high. On the same time, the cost of oil which is used to as a medium is also high. Absence of mechanical stresses that wear effects set up by gas pressure and oil movement. If air is used, then the wear and tear caused by the movement of air is not present. If an oil circuit breaker is used, then the parts which are present in the oil and the gas which is created by the decomposition of the oil will corrode the metal parts of the circuit breaker. So, air circuit breaker is superior than an oil circuit breaker in the point of maintenance. Elimination of cost of regular oil replacement that arises due to deterioration of oil with successive braking capacities. Since the oil which is present in the oil circuit breaker will be deteriorated because of decomposition of oil due to high temperature caused by the arc, and also ionization of oil takes place. Once oil is ionized, it gets decomposed, and this decomposed oil will present in the circuit breaker itself, and it will not be replaced or it will not get relived because the oil does not have such properties. So the waste oil or the ionized oil which is present inside the circuit breaker has to be removed, and it should be refilled with a new oil of greater dielectric strength. So the cost which is occur due to replacement of oil is more than a air circuit breaker. Relative inferior arc extinguishing properties of air may be offset by using various principles of our control and operation at high pressure. Since air is not a very good dielectric material than oil, some extinguishing properties are inferior than oil. So, we can use our different principles which we have studied earlier, and we can use that principle in air circuit breakers, and we can improve the dielectric property of the air, and we can control or we can extinguish the arc in an easier way. Working of an air circuit breaker. In air brake circuit breaker, contact separation and arc extinction take place in air at atmospheric pressure. We know that if an arc is present in the air, then the arc will behave as a free arc because the atmospheric pressure of the air cannot be increased without any other means of compressors because the arc is present in the natural air. High resistance principle is used in this circuit breakers. Arc is rapidly lengthened by means of arc runners and arc chutes, and arc resistance is increased by cooling, lengthening and splitting of the arc. So, in this method of high resistance, we use cooling of arc, lengthening of arc and splitting of arc in an air brake circuit breaker to control or quench the arc as soon as possible by a circuit breaker. These three methods which are adapted in an air brake circuit breakers helps us to extinguish the arc in a faster rate than oil circuit breakers. So, the demerits which is caused by the air circuit breaker is enhanced, or the advantages are enhanced by using high resistance method of arc interruption in an air brake circuit breaker. Arc resistance is increased to such an extent that voltage drop across arc becomes more than system voltage, and arc get extinguished at current zero of AC wave. Since the arc resistance is increased by using high resistance interruption methods, the voltage drop across the arc becomes more than the system voltage. So, the arc voltage becomes more so that the current which is supplied by the arc is resisted by the high resistance due to the principles of cooling, lengthening and splitting of arc. So, the arc get extinguished at current zero position of an AC wave. Arc brake circuit breakers are employed in DC circuits and AC circuits up to 12,000 volt. So, the ratings of the air brake circuit breakers are up to 12,000 volts. These air brake circuit breakers can be used for DC circuit as well as AC circuits. Such breakers are usually of indoor type and installed on vertical panels or indoor draw-out switchgears. These air brake circuit breakers are installed in an indoor power yard. So, the installation of air brake circuit breaker is made inside the power station inside a concrete room so that the vertical panels are mounted inside the power grid station, and some panels which are of draw out type switch gear so that for maintenance the switch gear can be drawn out and the maintenance can be made and it can be pulled back to the original position. AC circuit breakers are widely employed in indoor medium voltage and low voltage switch gears. So, the air brake circuit breakers which are used for AC extinguishing, controlling are of indoor type, and these indoor type air brake circuit breakers will have a lower voltage rating when compared to the other types of air brake circuit breakers of DC interruption types. Construction of air brake circuit breaker. The contact, separation and arc extinction take place in air at atmospheric pressure. Figure shows closed position of circuit breaker and current carrying contacts. In this figure, you can see the air brake circuit breaker. The air brake circuit breaker is in a closed position so that the two main contacts of the circuit breaker are connected together. The R core is a conduction path of hot plasma. This region is the R core region, where the arc is formed between these two regions, and this R core region will have the hot plasma gas or the arc, which is to be extinguished by the air brake circuit breakers. The surrounding medium consists of ionized air. So, under open position of an air brake circuit breaker, the surrounding medium over here will contain ionized air. So, this ionized air helps the arc to form and to restrike after current zero position. So, this ionized air should be removed or cooled down back to form deionized air by the air brake circuit breaker. This is a deionization of ionized air is a very important duty of an air brake circuit breaker to break the arc or to extinguish the arc. By cooling the arc, the diameter of the arc can be reduced. When we know that the cooling of arc will reduces the cross-sectional area of the arc, so the cooling of the arc is made by blowing out cold air into the circuit breaker or by making the arc to be cooled automatically through the windows or the arc chutes which is present in the air brake circuit breaker. The arc is extinguished by lengthening the arc, cooling the arc and splitting the arc. So, the arc which is produced in an air brake circuit breaker is extinguished by high resistance principle of lengthening, cooling and splitting the arc. So, these three methods are used in an air brake circuit breaker to extinguish the arc. The arc resistance is increased to such an extent that the system voltage cannot maintain the arc and the arc gets extinguished. Since the system voltage which is present in the power system will be decreased and the arc voltage or the potential difference between the two contacts of the arc gets decreased, so that the resistance of the arc gets increased due to high resistance principle. In this due course, the increasing of high resistance makes the arc to be interrupted, or it will deionize the medium which is present in the air circuit breaker, so that the arc can also be extinguished easily. Air brake circuit breaker is used for medium and low voltages. Breakers generally consist of three single pole switch units, each of one phases. If a three-phase supply is to be interrupted, then the air brake circuit breaker consists of three single poles, and these three single poles will be connected to the consecutive three phases of the circuit. They are linked together by a insulated crossbar. Since the three phases has three different poles, so the three poles should be opened or closed at a simultaneously together. So, a link circuit or a link crossbar is used, and this link crossbar is a insulated material, and this insulated material will helps the circuit breaker to open the three poles or close the three poles simultaneously together at any time of operation. It is operated by one or more mechanisms according to current rating. Since the current rating of the air brake circuit breaker decides the operating mechanism, if the current rating is very low, then we can use a manual trip or knife edge strip. If the current rating is very high, then a relay mechanism with the advanced numeric relays can be used, and a electromagnetic trip can also be used. So, on depending on the current rating, we can use a spring trip or a knife edge trip or a numeric relay trip or other types of advanced circuits to trip the circuit. Complete assembly, including the mechanism, is mounted on a panel. We know that the air circuit breakers are of indoor types. So, these indoor type air brake circuit breakers should be mounted in a panel, and this panel should be insulated. Panel is made of insulating material with arc resistance barriers on both sides of each panel. Since the air brake circuit breaker is installed in the indoor, so the circuit breaker can be accessed by humans, or the body of the circuit breaker can be touched by humans at any time of any course. So these panels out covering or the end guard of the switch gear should be insulated, and this insulating material should possess a very high dielectric strength so that the outer guard or the cover of the switchgear panel should not have any electrical contact with the live parts of the switchgear, and the arc resistant barrier should be present in the switchgear, because if arc is interrupted, the arc will flow in any direction. So this arc should not touch the outer cover of the switchgear. So arc resistance barriers should be installed on both sides of the each panel so that the arc will not touch the outer cover of the switchgear, so as to eliminate the electric shock to the person who is standing near the circuit breaker or the person who is maintaining the circuit breaker. Next, we will see some main parts of an air brake circuit breaker. First one is pole units. Each pole is made up on an independent insulating molded pieces. Here, the pole units are represented as the contact parts. So, these are the two contact parts of an air brake circuit breaker, and these two contact parts should be connected with the insulated material. And this insulated material should possess a very high dielectric strength. Poles are mounted to main contacts, arcing contacts, arc chutes, dielectric instantaneous release, and current transformer for operating thermal release. So, these poles which are mounted on the circuit breaker should have to possess the connection between the main contacts, which is shown here, and the arcing contacts, which is shown here, and the arc chutes, which are present in the above position, and also the two instantaneous releases, which were direct instantaneous release, and another one is current transformer for operating thermal release. So these two instantaneous releases are present in the switchgear itself to protect itself. The second part is contacts. There are two sets of contacts, main contacts and arcing contacts. The figure shows the main contact, and this one is the arcing contact. Main contacts conduct the current in the closed position of the breaker. So, when the circuit breaker is closed, these two main contacts will be touching together so that the current can pass from one contact to the other contact as easy as possible. Main contacts have low contact resistance and are silver plated. Since the main contact should have low resistance, so these main contact materials are plated with silver at the faces of the contact. Arc contacts are hard, heat resistant, and are made up of copper alloys. So here are arc contacts. These arc contacts are made up of alloys of copper, and these arcing contacts are very hard, and these arcing contacts will not melt in any situation that the temperature rises above 1000 degrees centigrade or more than above. So these arcing contacts should possess the two important properties. One, it should not melt on any circumstances, and the other property is it should be very hard enough so that the deterioration of metal should never happen. On opening main contacts, dislodges first, so the current is shifted to the arcing contact. So these two main contacts which are present over here should dislodge first, then only the arcing contacts can produce the arc at this position. If this two main contacts did not dislodge first, then the arc will present in the main contacts of the circuit breaker in this position. If arc is present over here, then this arc can damage the silver coating and the silver alloys which are used to make the material to be low resistance. So this main contact should dislodge first so that the arc will produce in the arcing contacts in the upper end of the circuit breaker. Arcing contacts dislodge later and arc is drawn between them. So the reason why the arc should be produced in the arcing contacts is the silver alloys which are present or coated in the main contacts are not of heat resistant type. If the arc is struck between the two main contacts, then the silver alloys plated will be eroded. For this reason, the arc should be produced in the arcing contacts. Arc is forced upward by electromagnetic force and thermal action. We can use blowout coil and arc runners, which are V-like plates present over here, to shift the arc towards the upward position of an air brake circuit breaker. Arc moves upwards and is split by arc splitter plates. Since the arc which is produced in the arcing contacts will move upwards due to electromagnetic forces which is present in its nature, this arc starts on get lengthening. So lengthening of arc take place at this position. If the lengthening of arc happens at once, the cross-sectional area of the arc starts to decrease. This will make the arc to get weakened. Arc is extinguished by lengthening, cooling and splitting. We know that the high resistance principle such as lengthening, cooling and splitting helps to extinguish the arc. In this circuit breaker, arcing horns are present, so the V-shaped form will help to lengthen the arc. Second, for cooling the arc, the ionized particles which are present over here are shifted up so that it will get contact with the cold air which is present over here. Similarly, arc chutes are present and the arc splitter plates are also present in the top of the circuit breaker. So this arc splitter plates and the arc chutes will help in splitting of the arc. If the arc is splitted into several pieces, so the voltage which is needed to maintain the arc get increased. Since the arc is splitted to a very higher degree of level, so that the voltage maintained in the arc gets decreased. So the arc itself extinguished by itself. Arc chutes are made up of an insulating materials. Arc resisting materials are surrounded at each pole units. The diameter of the arc chute depends on the number of arcing contacts. So we know that this is the arc chute which is present in the air brake circuit breaker. These arc chutes are made up of insulating materials, and the plates which are present in the arc chutes are of conducting material. The dimension of the arc chutes depends on the number of arcing contacts present in the air brake circuit breaker. So, if the arcing contacts which are present in the air brake circuit breaker is 3, then the arc shoots present will also be 3. The chute is shaped like a funnel with a restricted area at its lower position. So, these arc chutes which are present over here are in the shape of a funnel. So, the arc get splitted and it get extinguished at a easier rate. At top, arc chutes houses a steel plate. You can see in the above figure, at the top end, you can see a steel plate. This steel plates helps us to mount the circuit breaker to the above connections and acts as a rooftop of the circuit breaker. Steel plate function is to increase splitting speed of the arc into the arc chutes by magnetic action. We know that arc which is produced in the air brake circuit breaker has a magnetic type, and this magnetic type will help us to move the arc towards the upward direction. Since this arc current, arc magnetic field will cut the arc chute metal plates, then this metal plate will act as an opposite plate and it will attract the arc towards the upward direction. So, the metal plate which is present in the top of the air brake circuit breaker helps in increasing the splitting speed of the arc, and it also helps in increasing the magnetic action due to lifting the arc. It split the arc and result in increasing arcing voltage and ionizes plasma by a strong cooling action. So, this metal plate is placed in an outer section so that this outer section metal plate will be contact with the fresh cold air from the atmosphere. So, this metal plate will supply the cold air or radiate the chillness into the circuit breaker. So, the arc chutes and the metal divider plates present over here are cool enough to chill the arc. So, cooling of arc is made by the arc chutes and the metal plates which are present at the top position of the air brake circuit breaker. Since the arc is cooled, the arcing voltage which is present in the two contacts of the circuit breaker get increased. Due to splitting of arc, this increased in arcing voltage cannot be maintained for a longer period, so the arc get extinguished easily. Operating mechanism. Mechanism of AC circuit breakers is usually defined for manual operation. If a AC circuit is to be controlled, then air brake circuit breaker is operated in a manual way. Electrical operation such as electrical spring charge mechanism can be provided for a remote controlled process. If we need a remote controlled process of operation of air brake circuit breaker, then electrical spring charge mechanism can be used to control the air brake circuit breaker automatically during a short circuit fault. Most type of operating mechanism as lever and toggle or cam and roller system. So, the mechanical operation present in the air brake circuit breaker are lever and toggle or cam and roller system. These two mechanical operations are used to control the operating mechanism of an air brake circuit breaker. Moving contacts and its associated members are made as lightweight as practicable, since the moving contact has to move from one position to the other position, that is from open position to the closed position or from closed position to open position. The acceleration speed depends on the inertia of the material. So, the weight of the material should be reduced to increase the acceleration so that the arc can be extinguished at a faster rate, or the lengthening of arc can be achieved at a faster rate. So, the weight of the moving contacts should be minimized so that the arc can be extinguished easier. This lightweight can achieve very high braking speed. So the main point in operating mechanism is the moving contact which is present in air brake circuit breaker should considerably have a very light weight so that the braking speed is very high so that the lengthening of the arc is done in a minimum amount of time. So if the arc is lengthened in a faster rate, at once the cross-sectional area get decreased. So this property will make the arc to extinguish in a faster rate. Powerful springs are used to give rapid acceleration. So the spring mechanism which is present in this position will be having a powerful spring. We can also use the electromagnetic loaded springs so that the moving of or the accelerating of moving contacts can be made as fast as possible so that the contacts are separated at a faster rate and the arc is extinguished immediately. Mechanisms are invariable of the trip free type and in some designs for manual closing. So the air brake circuit breakers are made for automatic opening, but the closing procedure is manual. It includes a device that makes immediate tripping if any reversal occurs in the direction of motion of the operating handle. So if we want to trip the AC air brake circuit breaker, then the reversal of operating handle will immediately trip the air brake circuit breaker. This type of tripping is considered as manual. So automatic tripping can be achieved by using electromagnetic loaded with spring automatic release. There are 5 releases provided in an air brake circuit breaker. First one is overcurrent release, earth fault release, under voltage release, shunt trip release, instantaneous short circuit release. So these 5 protections are present inside the air brake circuit breaker. The overcurrent release performs 2 main important functions. To trip breaker on occurrence of a short circuit, this is a short time delayed operation. So this overcurrent release will trip the circuit breaker within a short time period so that the short circuit current is to be interrupted at once when it is formed. To trip breaker in case of sustained overload, whereas instantaneous short circuit release trips the circuit breaker when it is closed on a fault. So the breaker is tripped when it is overloaded. So the overloading of breaker happens when more current is passing through the contacts of the circuit breaker than its rating. So this percentage amount of increase will also trip the circuit breaker contacts due to overcurrent release. Thank you.